Everyone, Cat Cool here, back again with another video. Today we're back with some more Gran Turismo on the PlayStation. Continuing from last week, we're doing the second half of the Grand Valley Endurance. So let's crack on, get these tyres changed and get back out on the track. Right, we're in first place, so that's good. Yeah, oh, that wasn't a good start, was it? Oh, come on, Rick, concentrate. Oh. Yeah. Amazing though, when you look at these circuits and how much they have changed between this one and obviously the modern day Gran Turismo's. When I say modern day, I mean Gran Turismo 6, obviously, because this isn't in Gran Turismo Sport, but... Oh, God. Good job we've got a nice, big, massive lead, isn't it? Catching up another bat marker. You know, it's not just graphically how the track's changed, it's how long it is and the corners and stuff like that. There's a lot of them that were very different when they was introduced on the more modern versions of the game. I hate braking into there. I really do. Thank you. hope they aren't going to actually fit in. Well, not that it really makes that much difference, but... Oh, God. Well, I'm not going too well today, am I? Generally, I can get about 15 laps out of a set of tyres, so... That was terrible. So hard to correct it because the analog stick's so sensitive. I know this game was never designed to have analog controls anyway, but I think the first one that was designed to have analog controls was Gran Turismo 2, I think. Obviously, when this was released, it was just a directional pad. Now we've done an hour. Well, not in this video, but you know what I mean. make sure I break in plenty of time now. Would also be nice if it told me how far in front I am, not just my particular lap time. Ah, 39 laps in. And I'm going off the road again. No surprise there, really. Am I overtaking this guy again? He must have pitted. So hopefully they're all starting to pit now. Well, he doesn't really make that much difference anyway, but because I think we're miles in the lead. Oh, catching somebody else up. Oh, it's him again. Yeah, they've got to have been in the pits, haven't they? Yeah, I'm not that good. Gonna be time for another pit stop soon. You see the tyres are starting to wear a bit now. Just as I was starting to catch somebody else. This is Primera again. Yeah. They must have all been in the pits. Must have been. There's Sunday in the pits now. But we're going to be pitting again very soon. Definitely a distinct lack of grip starting to appear now. Right, we'll be pitting in at the end of this lap. Now make it an even 15 laps per stint, and then that'll take us to the end. Definitely, that front left's not very happy with me, I don't think. Getting a real, starting to come orange, that front left tyre. There we go. Right, changing the tyres. Must say the pit stops are a lot faster than they are on the more modern Gran Turismos. Here come people unlapping themselves. Oh. Slight mistake there. What's this car? This the other GTO? I think it must be, you know. Yeah. Oh dear. I'm blaming the tires. Daisy. Right, there we go. Passed him again. That serves him right going in the sun there for hitting me, doesn't it? So far, it's going pretty well. I don't know why I'm saying oh dear, because I'm clearly massively in the lead. Yeah, crazy to think really that this is the game that made me buy a PlayStation. At the time, I was more of a PC gamer. Oh, pardon me, PC gamer. Went to visit a friend of mine that I've been friends with for years since school. And he had a PlayStation and he had this game. And so he was chatting and whatever. So I started asking him what he was playing. And the thing that drew me to this is the way that the game's structured. At the time, there was nothing like it. And it just... I was like, yeah, got to get myself one of these PlayStations. And that was actually... the first games console I ever owned. I never had games consoles when I was younger. Nintendo, Super Nintendo. I never had any of that. I was always into my computers. You know, I had like Commodore 64s, Commodore Amigas, PC... Oh, here comes our friend. I must have lapped this car about 3 times. Yeah, I mean, did Polyphony... Oh, dear. Did Polyphony Digital even think this was going to turn into the juggernaut it is today? Gran Turismo, when they originally made this game, or... did they just think, well, we'll try it and see what happens, you know? Who knows? Obviously, only Kazunori knows the answer to that question, but... no, it'd be quite interesting to know, you know, what their mindset was. Was it like, we're going to make this into a great series? And I know a lot of people don't like Gran Turismo, but I'm not one of those people. It's a big part of my gaming history. You know, I've played them all. Oh, we're catching our friend up again here, look. We are, if I can keep it on the track. Oh dear. Come on, get your Mazda out of my way. Well, not many laps to go now. What we've been driving for, 1 hour 30 minutes, obviously not in this video, but in total for the endurance, that's not too bad. I thought it was going to be about a 2 hour endurance, but it appears not. I'd probably say about 1 hour 40 minutes, something like that. Ain't too bad really for an endurance, is it? Certainly better than the ones in Gran Turismo 4 and 5, like the 24 hours and 12 hours and 9 hours and stuff like that. Oh, I'm off the road again. maybe even more, like 1 minute 40, I'd say, probably. Not 1 minute 40, 1 hour 40. 1 minute 40 would be much of an endurance, would it? Be overtaking this car in front of us if I don't stop making these silly mistakes. There's somebody in the pits with only a few laps to go. I just want to know what the next back marker is, what car it is. I'm not going to find out if I keep doing stuff like that. Or that. But it's one I've already overtaken already. We're about to find out. Yeah, it looks like it is. Oh well. It's just the same cars over and over that I've lapped. Oh, apart from I lapped the GTO, didn't I? Well, we enter the final lap then. This is it. Push now, push now. The white flag is out. This is the final lap. I am a bit mental, in case you haven't already realised. There we go, across the line. Hold on. How far behind us are they? Will it tell us? No, it just says running, running, running. Castro Super. Oh, so the GTO was third. So we managed to lap him. Just not the Supra. But how much cash do we get for that? Yeah, all right. Yeah. 300,000. Not bad. What's it doing? Don't scare me, please. Oh dear, oh dearie me. Right, that's it for Grand Valley then. So that concludes this week's video, I'm afraid. But next week we will be attacking the special stage Route 11 All Night Endurance, which I probably quite enjoy that actually. But yeah, many thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it to be notified next time I'm live streaming or when I upload new videos. You can also follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and I have a Facebook page. Links to those are in the description. Take it easy, everyone, and I'll catch up with you soon. Bye for now.
Mm-hmm.